But today let me share with you a breath principle that you could apply on movements where you move dynamically, not only that, any movements that you want to create more space and lightness inside the body, arm balancing, jumping, even back bend. So any elements actually apply this inherently. That breath, especially when the abundance are very efficient, flowing directly to breath, has its inherent way of rising. So we can really utilize that rising behavior of breath for us to keep the inner body open and light as we perform the elements, and even when you meditate later on. So the element that I will be sharing with you, or the asana, the movement that I will be sharing with you, when we are sitting and we want to jump back behind you, or you could actually apply this from the back and jump forward. It's really, really. Now, the principle is not commonly discussed out there. Now, it's actually the opposite of what is commonly taught. But this is how I feel the energy as it flows inside the body. It has something to do with the energy passing through the backs of the body and all the way to the tops of the spine. And when you're able to direct your breath, meaning the sensation, the skill directing the breath there, it actually makes the back of the body light. So in the jump back or the jump forward, even handstand, being on balance, you can apply this principle to float. So this will create that floating effect in the element. So let's try to be joking. So let me get my stretch so you can see. Right. So as we breathe through it, inherently, commonly, the pattern of the flow of breath is in. That's commonly yes. But if you want to alter it, if you're able to alter it, actually allow it to pass through the back, so you can feel the breath is a session that passes through the backs of the body, part of the hips, the backs of the ribs, and all the way up here. So it feels like this of a loop here, and that really literally will lift you off the earth. Yeah, as you push away. Yeah. Right. So instead of doing you're gonna do this. So you just don't push away this elongating action. So as you push, you can send the breath here. And that will lift you up, and flow back to a jump position. Alright, so let's start that. First, exhale, open the as you inhale. That one hand, now as opposed to inhale. Exhale, prepare, inhale. Alright, and you apply that with your hands to flow. You have exhale, inhale, as you contact the body, and the spine will go to a light flexion inside, and it elongates like a bone behind it. Set, and back. So, you see the difference now as opposed to this, for example. I will do it with the chest opening forward. Yes, so you don't need to open it, but it's heavy because the body is getting in the way. So, in other words, when you want to lift yourself off the earth, organically inside, you're actually using the back hips. To hold this in and to create the space behind you to push up. So let's repeat that. Exhale, and you can open the pathway, actually your Chaturbhuja, and the Mulabandha, you can actually feel them for the weight of the physical body of the earth. Exhale, inhale here, next and back. Alright. And then you can actually feel the breath here. Then it goes up. And it starts from really the basic hips. And then the throat lock will organically connect those points. And you rise up. Of course, it will be an under there. Well, organically connected, because this one is the most active when you want to support just your body afterwards. It will be an under is very active when you want to create floating action. But now, you're able to utilize more of the Chaturbhuja and the Dhyanabandha to do more of support. Right. Now, how about when we jumping forward to start saying first, exhale if you want to loosen, because the exhalation has a way of letting the joints and the rest of our body relax. Yeah? So you can like that. Yeah? Next time, breathing. See that? As opposed to inhale, yeah? Inhale. We're actually doing the opposite. Yeah, as you breathe in, yeah? Inhale. Jump off the stand. So let's repeat that. Yeah. Inhale. Yeah, jump off the stand. Alright, so now. So inhale. You can hook it from the inside to the back. And up you go. The hips will rise up and flow up to the same position. Exhale. Inhale. Continue stand position. And now that we're doing for example, from this hand, and then you jump back. It's the same actually, it's really the same. Yeah? Very, very similar. Yeah. As we in front, open the sides of the bottom, the sides of the feet, maybe it doesn't matter. Alright, exhale, you may want to shift a bit. Loose it. Inhale. Right? Exhale, inhale. Back. Yeah. If you want to do a handstand, same, yeah, similar, yeah. Same principle. Yeah. Exhale, shift forward, yeah. Inhale, yeah. Exhale, inhale. You're lifting yourself up all the way. Do your handstand. And then here, yeah, feel flat, inhale, push. Yeah. Release, inhalation. And you want to repeat that. So with the physical going to apply, yeah? Even if you do the back and say that, because if you do if you want to do the back things, then you really want to create the space. But instead of you doing like that, to send the vertical, inhale it, exhale up a little bit, in. But you're going to an extension. Instead of a flexion, but the same. We're going to draw it up, and the breath will actually come from the inside of the hips, here, all the way here, but in the back here. You want to open this up a bit to make room, the chest, the right, and so on. And so we're ready now to allow the breath to go inside and in different directions of the body inside, especially when you allow it to pass through the backs of the body, it becomes so powerful. Nice. So, yes, that's our lesson. See you in the next tutorial.